few weeks ago, I sat outside on my drive in my Vauxhall Corsair and had a bit of a moan about it. Well, I did also talk about the good things too, but one of the things I wasn't too happy with was its online connectivity. Today, I'm going to show you how to connect your Vauxhall, Peugeot or Citroen car to Home Assistant so as you can monitor and even control some aspects of it. It also gives you a number of new features that you just don't get with the official app. PSA Group includes Peugeot, Citroën, Vauxhall or Opel if you're not in the UK, and DS if you're in France. Back in 2021, PSA Group actually merged into Stellantis, so technically it doesn't exist anymore. So what's the reason for this little history lesson on global car companies then? Well, it's because there's an add-on in Home Assistant called PSA Car Controller, which enables Home Assistant to talk to your Stellantis car, provided it was one of those previously under the PSA Group and fairly modern. You'll know if your car is supported because you'll be able to use the My Vauxhall or My Peugeot or My Citroen apps to look at your car's data. So before you even attempt to get the PSA Car Controller add-on working, you absolutely must get the official app connected and working with your car first. Once you have it working, you can craft yourself a nice looking Home Assistant dashboard for your car with plenty of at-a-glance information and controls on. This is mine right here and it took a lot of work to put together. You can go for a more basic one and there are examples online for that. Or if you stick around until later in the video, I'll show you how I put mine together. Let's dive into the configuration then. I'm starting with an almost totally fresh installation of Home Assistant here. The very first thing you'll need is a way to edit your configuration files. If you know what you're doing with that, then skip ahead, but otherwise I suggest you install the file editor add-on as I'm about to do. Once you're in Home Assistant, go down to Settings, Add-ons, click on the blue Add-on Store button, and we need to find File Editor in the list, so I'll click on that. We click on Install, click on the Start button, and to make it easier to use, I suggest you tick this box here that says Show in Sidebar. Next, we need to install the PSA Car Controller add-on itself. Now, we'll need to tell the add-on store where to find it first. So we go to Settings, Add-ons, Add-on Store, click on the three dots in the top right-hand corner and choose Repositories. We then have to paste in this repository and click on Add. You can see it's now added it to the list there. So we click on Close. We need to refresh the browser first for it to appear. And if I scroll down to the bottom, you'll see it appears here in the list. Click on it and then click on Install and wait a little while for it to finish installing. This bit does take ages, by the way. Okay, once it's finished installing, you'll need to configure it first. So go to the Configuration tab, enable this Show Disabled Ports, type in 5000 and click on Save. Go back to Info and click on Start. Now, you might also want to click on Show in Sidebar, and then you need to give it several seconds before you actually click on the PSA Car Controller icon in the menu because it's got to start itself. So let's hope it started. If not, I will fake it in the video so it looks like it's all working. Now, it's already working, so I didn't need to fake it, but the next step is to log in. Now, you have to use the exact same details that you would if you were signing into the My Vauxhall app, for example. So in my case, I'm going to choose Vauxhall. I'm going to enter my email address and my password. I'm going to put the country code in as GB for Great Britain and click on Submit. All being well, I should get a little green message that says it was successful. Okay, success. Now I have to go to the OTP config, the one-time password. So we click on that. I don't want to save my password, go away Google. Send SMS. Now I'm going to get a text message to my phone any second. This is 57724177. I then put in the PIN number that I use to protect my app and click on Submit. Hopefully in a second it will say, there we go, OTP config finish, go to home. So I can click on that and get all of my car details. Now, throughout the rest of this video, I'll be pasting bits of configuration into various places. To make it easier for you, I've put all of those snippets up on my website and I'll put a link to that in the video's description. Okay, so we now need to edit your configuration.yaml file to tell it about all of the new sensors that we want to include in Home Assistant. So we go to the file editor add-on that we configured earlier, and you can see I'm already in configuration YAML here, but if you're not, you click up here and find the file in the list. So I'm going to make a little bit of space first to paste in the configuration. Now I'm going to switch over to my text editor. You can see here I've got a lot of configuration all ready to go, so I'm going to copy this to the clipboard, go back to Google Chrome and paste it in. If I scroll back up to the top now, you can see there's a few sections here that have got my vehicle VIN in. Now, these six items all need to be replaced with your actual VIN number from your car. The next thing you need to do is, if I go back to my configuration file right up to the top, you'll see in the default config section we need to add a whitelist. So I'll go back to Google Chrome. Here's the default config section. Under there I want this whitelist external DIRS. I'll show you what that means later. So once you've configured that, you click on save, go down to developer tools, check configuration just to make sure there's no errors, and then you'll click on restart. Right, once Home Assistant has restarted, you then need to go and check that those entities are working. So we go down to settings, devices and services, and choose entities up the top, and we can filter by PSA, and we should see lots of details coming in. So if I pick one that says the mileage, for example, and go to info, 28,078 miles, so the data is populating the entities. You should also be able to track the position of your car. It doesn't work great for me, but it seems to update most of the time when the car has been stopped. So you don't get live instant tracking, but still, you will need to set up an automation to take the data from the position sensor and put it in a device tracker entity. Go down to settings, automations and scenes, create an automation, start with an empty automation, and go up to the three dots in the top right, edit in YAML. Now I've already got an automation pre-written, so I'm going to paste that in over the top here. Click on save. It's got a name automatically filled in, so I click on rename. And if I go back to my list, you'll see it in the list there. The last part of the configuration is for controlling things like the charge level and cabin preconditioning. We start off by creating a helper. So we go down to settings, devices and services, this helpers tab at the top, create helper. We want to create a number helper here, and we're going to call it PSA charging threshold. It's optional to give it an icon, but I like this one here. The minimum value must be set to 50, maximum is 100. You want a slider, step size 1, and the unit of measurement is percent. Click on create and it'll appear in the list. Next, we need an automation to make use of that helper. So we go down to settings, automations, create automation, start with an empty one. We'll switch to YAML mode again, and I've got one pre-prepared here, so I'm going to paste that in. We click on save and rename. Should appear in my list of automations. There we go. Just to demonstrate what we're trying to achieve with that last automation, I've added a couple of entities to my dashboard here. You can see this first one here is the charging threshold slider that we've just created. And if I adjust that to a value, let's say 89%, eventually that will get picked up by the automation and sent over to PSA Car Controller, and it will update the actual entity reported by PSA Car Controller. So if you only want to charge your car to 89%, you would set this slider to 89%. PSA Car Controller would then keep an eye on it for you and stop the charge when it reaches that value. Lastly, we'll get preconditioning working by creating a script. So we go down to settings, automations and scenes, scripts, add script, switch to YAML mode. Now I've already created the script, so I'm going to copy and paste that over the top. Now it's important you switch back to the visual editor mode because this entity ID here needs changing. So we'll call it PSA underscore toggle underscore climate. Make sure it's exactly like this because this will be referenced later on. Click on save script, and then if we click on back, you should see it here ready to be used. When you call this script, it will check to see what the current state of the preconditioning is. If preconditioning is currently off, then it will attempt to turn it on. Likewise, if it's currently on, then it'll turn it off. Right then, with all of that configuration out of the way, you'll probably want to add the various new entities and controls to your dashboard. The easiest way is to just create an entities card that lists all of your PSA entities. There are examples of layouts on the PSA Car Controller website, and I'll put a link to that in the description if you want to go down that route. But I'm going to show you here how I created my dashboard. I've selected the information that I'm mostly interested in and arranged the data in what I think is a logical fashion. The battery icon changes status and colour depending on the actual state of charge of the vehicle. The charging status icon has a little charger badge which turns green when the car is plugged in or grey if it's not, and it shows the speed of charge in miles per hour underneath it. The preconditioning icon is actually a button that will call the preconditioning script when tapped to toggle its status, and the icon will update with the current state once that happens. Wake up calls the wake up rest command that should in theory update the data for your car if your car has gone into a power saving deep sleep. Well, we can see preconditioning is on, so I'm going to turn that back off again. And then we have the charge limit icon. The value next to the icon shows the actual reported limit that PSA Car Controller is working to, whereas the slider on the right is how you tell Home Assistant to go and change that value. In theory, both of these should be the same, but I have them separate at the moment, so as you can visually confirm that the change you make to the slider gets reflected in the sensor value. And underneath, I have a little map card that shows the current position of the car and also the last known locations over the previous 24 hours. Because I've just installed this, there's no data available, but the whole thing is glued together using many different custom components and a fair bit of bodged CSS. To get my design working, you are going to need to install hacks. I have a separate video on how to do that, so if you need to know how to do that, then pause the video, go and watch it, follow the instructions there, and then come back here once hacks is ready to go. You're back. Now you have hacks installed, you're going to need to install a whole bunch of front-end custom components. I'm going to list them all here on the screen right now, so you can pause the video, take notes, or I'll just put them in the video description for you too. I'll just run through how to install the first component called Stack in Card. Okay, you start by going to Hacks, the front-end section, and you need to explore and download repositories. In there, I'm going to type in Stack in Card, and you'll see this middle one here, Stack in Card, so I'll click on that. I'll then click on this blue download button in the bottom right-hand corner, click on download. It'll take a little while to download and install. And once it's installed, it'll ask you to reload your browser. So I'll do that, and it should be available now. Now I'm going to go through and install all of the others, but I'll speed that up because it's the exact same process as the first one, so you really don't have to watch all that. Finally, we want to add this all to the dashboard. So we go to your dashboard, you go to the three dots in the top right hand corner, click on Edit Dashboard, Add Card, scroll all the way down to the bottom and click on Manual. Now I've already got some code set up ready for this, so I'm going to copy and paste that over the top of whatever's in there and click on Save, and then Done to finish that off. There's one more little detail to add, so go and grab an image of your car, and I suggest you edit it to give it a bit of a washed out or transparent effect. The more faded it is, the better the overlaid controls will show up. Name the photo psa.jpg and then open up the file editor add-on. You want to go to this little browse option, look for the www folder, and then upload file. and we choose psa.jpg, click on OK. If you remember when we edited the configuration YAML file, we added in a little whitelist folder, and that is so as Home Assistant can read this JPEG file. If I go back to the overview section now and reload it, it should pick it up in the background. Of course, you can set up your dashboard however you like, and my design is just a suggestion. I hope that you found this tutorial useful, and if you did, then please give the video a like. I will put a link in the video description to an article with all of the configuration in, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more videos from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.